Hello, welcome to the self-planning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start Unit 24, Environment and Infrastructure. And our topic is Impact of Urbanization on Environmental Quality. Due to increased human activities in the urban centers arising out of the industrialization and commercialization, there is a copious use of water, energy, and other raw materials, transforming them into goods and services and returning the waste into the environment in the form of emissions and not usable solid waste. Therefore, the cities are becoming the major contributors to local, regional, and global environmental problems. The extent of resource used by a city can be captured by its ecological footprints. The term coined by the Canadian environmentalist William Rees is concerned with the defining the amount of land that is required to supply a city with food and natural resources, as well as the area of growing vegetation required to absorb its carbon dioxide output. Rees describes this as the carrying capacity of the local and distant ecosystems, an approach that was later adopted by the Herbert Grider, who was influential in drawing up the British proposals for Habitat II. He argued that the wild cities occupy only 2% of the world's land surface. They consume as much as 75% of the world's resources. In presenting his argument, Grider used London as an example to show how the footprint extends over more than 125 times the city's actual area. One should, however, compare the ecological footprint of cities with that of the alternatives. Possibly, it is not urbanization per se that stresses the environment, but the level of living and affluence, and if combined with stupendous population growth, then the impact could be disastrous. It has been observed that large cities of the poorer countries are growing at a much faster rate than smaller cities in the developed world, and India forms no exception of it. Such a heavy and uncontrolled growth places a heavy burden on environment and infrastructure. Resource shortages are intensified by ever-increasing demands for services that need to be supplied at the rate, which often exceeds the country's economic growth. The current status of environment and infrastructure of the Indian cities raises certain questions in our mind. How rapidly are we urbanizing? What is the impact of rapid urbanization on environment, infrastructure, and society at large? What should we do to make our urban system sustainable? In order to address the first question, we should look into the picture of urbanization in India. Now, let us discuss the pattern and trends of urbanization in India in 1991 to 2001. The pattern and trend of urban population and the number of towns in India during 1901 to 2001 shows that total urban population has increased more than 10 times, from 26 million in 1901 to 285 million in 2001. Whereas the total population has increased less than 5 times from 238 million to 1027 million during the same period. A continuous increase has been noticed in the percentage of urban population from 11% in 1901 to 17% in 1951 to further 28% in 2001. In the same fashion, the number of towns has also increased from 1916 in 1901 to 2422 in 1951 and then 5161 in 2001. This reveals the process of rapid urbanization in India. Now let us discuss growth in the number of million plus cities in India, 1991 to 2001. The growth in the number and population of the million plus cities in India during 1991 to 2001, there was only 1 million plus city in 1901 in India, then has increased to 35 in 2001. The total population had also increased in million plus cities from 1.51 million in 1901 to 107.88 million in 2001, showing almost a 50-fold increase. The percentage decadal growth rate in total population of million plus cities was noticed to be highest during 1941 to 1951, which may be attributable to partition of the country. The percentage of total population living in million plus cities has also shown a considerable increase over the years. Now let us discuss population growth rate in the four leading metropolis in India. More than threefold increase has been noticed in the population of Delhi in 100 years from 0.41 million to 1901 to 12.8 million in 2001. Whereas there has been 20-fold increase in Mumbai population from 0.8 million to 16.4 million from 1901 to 2001. However, Chennai has experienced more than tenfold increase in its total population during the last 100 years, whereas Kolkata has experienced the lowest increase in its total population among the metropolitan cities in the last 10 decades. The maximum growth rate has been noticed during 1941 to 1951. Highest in Delhi, followed by Mumbai and Chennai. However, Kolkata has recorded a comparatively lower growth rate during the same period. This was the era of partition in India, when a huge influx of migration has taken place in big cities. After independence, Delhi experienced a highest decadal growth rate in its total population in all the censuses from 1951 to 2001, followed by Mumbai, where the growth rate was about 40% during those census years. On the other hand, Kolkata experienced continuous declining decadal growth rate from 1951 to 2001. Chennai has experienced a mixed pattern of a high and low decadal growth rate during the last 50 years. Initially, Kolkata was the most populous city in India till 1981, but Mumbai surpassed it in 1991 census. Again, Delhi is expected to cross the population of Calcutta in the next census of 2011. if both cities will experience the same pattern of growth rate. Thus, it is evident that Mumbai and Delhi metropolis are experiencing profound growth in their population. Thus, the sharp increase in population in urban India, particularly in the metropolitan city, is particularly due to the scope for commercial activities and significant job opportunities. Facilities such as health, education, infrastructure, for example, roadways, telecommunications, airports, railways, and ports, are also better in metropolitan regions. Thus, the major changes that have occurred in India's urban scene in the post-independence period are influx of refugees and their settlements, particularly in the urban areas of northern India. Building of new administrative cities such as Chandigarh, Bhubaneswar, and Gandhinagar. Construction of new industrial cities and townships near major cities. Rapid growth of metros. Stagnation and, in some cases, decline of small towns. Massive increase in squatters and proliferations of slums in metro cities and dramatic changes in the urban rural fringes. Deteriorating urban environment, both physical and social, and finally, tremendous pressure on urban infrastructure. In fact, the positive role of urbanization in India has been often overshadowed by the deterioration in the environment and quality of life in the cities, often caused by widening gap between demand and supply of services and infrastructure. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.